Today I will be showing you how you can make a simple but colorful rainbow journal. I've cut my cardstock colors to size to fit my platform, as well as it's the right size for the die that I'm going to use. And I'm using the Art by Marlene Art Journal die that I showed you and used also in the previous video. I added the cardstock to the platform and added the die on top with a plate on top and then run it through the machine. So I did the same for all the colors. Now I have some strips that came off the side of the cardstock that I cut to size so it fits the platform also. And I added them in the middle of the die and I add some tape so it will stay in place. And I add a small plate on top because I don't have to run the complete die through. I only have to do that small piece. And I roll it back because it's only that part that I want to cut. So I peel off the tape and I add it on my die cutting machine on the handle because I can use it again for all the other pieces that I'm going to cut because I'm going to do the other ones also. And then I only need 5 colors. Now I'm going to add some interest to the inside pages by using a die. This isn't a die, this is a stencil. By using a stencil and some ink, and I use ink in slightly darker color than my stencil is. No, then I use ink that is a slightly darker color than my paper is. And I add it with my blending tool, just a simple ink blending sort of. It's not really blending, it's just adding ink with an ink blending tool. So I just add some of the pattern. I just pick pieces of the pattern of this stencil. And I'm twisting and turning my stencil a little bit to see if I want to add a little bit more of the pattern. And I mostly add my pattern on the top and the sides. I'm adding a pattern on both sides of the pages and I'm using different stencils. So pick different stencils from your stash or pick a new one or pick the ones I have, whatever you like. And I just pick a variety of stencils that I think will look pretty on my pages. I'm just adding a pattern on the different pages, on different pieces, using bits of the stencil. You don't have to use the complete stencil. You can use a part of the stencil, just the edge or the center, or just make an edge of the center. It's all up to you. I'm doing it this way, but this is just a starting point to give you an idea what you can do. I just add the ink again, same with a turning motion. Don't press too hard because you're working with a stencil, and if you press too hard, you are going to ruin your sponge and you don't want to do that. Or maybe you want to, but it's just a tip. You don't have to listen to me. You never have to listen to me, really. You can ink up your blending tool again if you want to, but you can also use the little bit lighter color. And that will give you a soft shade of the same color, which is also a fun way to use the same ink and to get some variation on your page. Now, I'm working on a mini album that I'm going to show you, but you don't have to make a mini album. You can also use this for a card. You can just dress up a card like this on the inside because, well, it's something else and it's a bit different than what you normally do maybe. And also the front cover of my album that I will show you at the end, of course, when I'm finishing up my album. That's also something that you can totally use to create a card because, well, options, thinking options, always thinking options. It's basically whatever you prefer, just don't overthink it. Don't overthink it, just move your stencils around a little bit, then just add that ink on your page and don't overthink it because, well, overthinking doesn't necessarily make your design better. Often it doesn't. I'm finishing up the last pages with some pattern and ink, and then I'm going to work on the mini album. So I'm going to fold the pages first. First I fold them double, I line them up, and then I go over the fold a little, and then I make a nice crisp crease with my bone folder. I go over it a few times so my fold is really nice and crisp. And I do that for all the pages. And then the mini pieces that I cut, I'm going to fold them in the same way and also go over them with the bone folder to get a nice sharp crease. Then I added some tape. I added tape to the mini pieces on the outside of the open side. And with these pieces, I'm going to attach the pages to each other. So I peeled away the backing on one side and now I line up the piece with the closed part of the page. And then I peel away the backing. Then I do the same for the other piece. I'm going to peel away the backing and fold that. And then I add my second page with the closed part also on the right side. I line it up and I make sure it's straight and then I press it down. And then I'm going to open up my page. I hold the page in place and peel away the backing. And then I check again and if it's straight and then I press it down. And I'm going to do the same for all the other pieces. Now the higher you get or the thicker your album gets, the harder it gets. So make sure to check every time that you line it up at the beginning of the album. So where you open the pages on that side, on the open side. So the pages are nicely stacked on top of each other. And they're not wonky. Unless you're going for a wonky album, then you don't have to check. Then you can just go ahead. So I'm doing all the pages and now you can see that you have some space at the spine and that will give you some nice space to fill your album with pictures or with things. There is a space to expand. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cover one side of the strip that attaches both pages with a piece of collage paper. And this colorful paper is thin paper, so it won't add much to the thickness of the album, which is great. And I also already had that for my paper beads, so I'm going to use it again because I like to use my stuff. Then I'm going to dress up all the left sides of the pieces that attach the pages so that a seam is covered. And the last thing I'm going to do for the inside of the album is I'm going to make a pocket. I've cut this piece also with the die and I rounded two of the straight corners with a corner rounder. And then I'm just adding my pocket to my page with some double-sided adhesive. And this is a quick flip through the album with matching collage paper for the strip and the pocket. Next I'm going to work on my front cover. I cut a big flower and this is a nice big size flower which gives you a really pretty focal point on, well, any project. Now there are lots of tiny pieces and I use a nail brush to push them out so I get most of the pieces out. And there you go, you have a nice big flower. I also have a square piece with strips from the colors that I used for the pages. And I added that on double-sided adhesive. And I cut a flower out of the middle of the page. And I'm going to use some collage paper to add behind the flower. So I cut a bit of the green to add to the center of the flower. And now I'm going to add my collage paper to the back of the rainbow piece. I put the backing back in place so it doesn't stick to my desk. And now I'm going to add my flower in place. I'm adding some glue on a scrap piece of paper and I pick it up with a sponge. And this is a great way to add some glue to intricate dies. So I'm adding it in place on my card and then I press it down. Next, I'm going to add my flower to a square piece of dark blue card. And this way it will stand out more on the cover of my page. I folded the corner of the backing piece and then I add my piece in place and I hold it down. I check if it's in the right spot. Then I peel away the rest of the backing while I push the panel down. And this will make sure that you get your piece straight on. Next, I'm going to make a fun element to add on the front cover. And this will be a nice place to put my sentiment or my title or whatever you want to call it. So I cut a few small strips of the same colors again and I'm adding those with glue. I just add a bit of glue on the dark blue piece for the inside strips. For the two strips on the outside, I'm going to add some glue on the strip itself so I'm not making a mess. And then I cut off the excess bits that are sticking out. And I did this on purpose so I don't have to aim, so this is way easier. Next, I cut the word rainbow with separate letters that I added to a yellow piece because I want a little bit of dimension. I'm adding another strip of the yellow that I just glue behind it. And then I'm going to glue that piece to my arrow. Then I have some branches that also come with the flower dye. And I cut that out of green, and now I'm going to measure again. And one is a little bit too long, so I'm going to cut off a little piece. And then I add some glue to my branches, and I'm going to add them in place. And I keep measuring with my rainbow arrow, so it will end up where I planned it. I added some double-sided adhesive to the back of my arrow, and now I'm going to add that in place. And then when it's straight, I just peel away the backing, and then I cut off the excess bit. And now I'm going to add the complete piece to the front cover, and you can see this will make a really pretty card too. So this is the complete finished mini album with the stretchable spine, and this will give you lots of space to add pictures, quotes, tags or other knickknacks, and I think this will make a nice gift, or you can make one for yourself, of course, or use this as a starting point to make a card. I hope you are inspired to hop into your craft room and get creative and make something pretty. And as always, make sure to keep on crafting.